we have now some time to discuss about coaching education, mainly coaching organization, mainly from World Archery. We will refer sometimes to some other countries. So, as Mr. Lee has introduced this morning, we have a new coaches committee that has been elected in July during the latest Congress in Copenhagen. And we have a second department, let's say, in charge of coaching that I have introduced also this morning. This is the former committee, a part of it, because one of the visa problems I was missing on the picture. But as I said, it has been, the new one has been elected in 2015. But this is a committee that is existing for years. We had many well-known people on this committee, Sherry Rowe, Juan Carlos Soldado, Kim Yong Tak, many people. In the past, this committee was helping us to develop archery in the countries through coaching, through improvement of the coaches, with more coaches, better educated coaches. But at the last Congress, it has been decided that now, from now on, the committee will help World Archery mainly with feedbacks on organization of tournaments, the main events. How to run better events, better for the participants, for the coaches, for the organizer, for everybody, even for the media. So there is a little change here, which means that coaching education will be mainly directed by our department, Eka and me. Nevertheless, yesterday again, the committee gave some very valid input on the committee, on the coaching development. And we always welcome your suggestions. So don't hesitate to discuss with Deka, myself, and of course the committee on any suggestion for coaching education. So, about development and coaching education, we mainly strive to help the countries that have not yet high levels, that are not yet in the elite family. So how we help them? This is what we see now. First, our goal is to have a maximum of countries having their own national coaching certification program. So last year, for example, even this year, we had some missions to help some countries. Sometimes we send someone, I went for example in Israel, Malta, to help them. But we have also here, for instance, Ranjit. Where are you, Ranjit? Ranjit over there, far back from Sri Lanka. Welcome, Ranjit. We communicate together to develop a national coaching system in Sri Lanka. He does it, maybe, of course. Very good job. So we can help, but just help. We cannot take your place for that. So we need a strong will first, then we can. So how we can help to develop a national coaching certification program? With the former committees, we have produced a lot of tools, I would like to say. What kind of tools? Manuals, of course. Some guides for making equipment. We have also some documents to conduct a coaching course. This document is mainly used by the coach trainers. We will explain soon what are the coach trainers. And we have, of course, different projects. One big project is to develop an e-library, library of coaching, teaching subjects, how to train. That means when it will be done, you will, for example, type on our website how to teach, Bosling introduction, and you will have access to a lot of documents, written documents, video, whatever, explaining what you can do, run, and conduct as exercise to teach Bosling introduction. But it will not be limited to the shooting form. There will be also articles about psychological development, making a training plan, and so on. It's a huge project. If you are interested in helping us in this, welcome, because we are not a lot. And we have already about 2,500 documents to feed to this library. We can see on the left-hand side, we have also a program mainly for the physical education teachers, but used in many clubs also, many federations even, which is called the Beginner Award Program. That it is a guide for the coach, explaining what should be instructed first in knowledge of the beginner, skills, and the beginner has also to perform some score to get the white arrow, and after there is another challenge for the black arrow, blue, red, and golden. So I don't know if you are familiar to this program, but it is online also and from our website. And some years ago, in 2009, we have introduced the first category of coaches that were actually certified. It is coach trainers. Coach trainers are those who educate the coaches. So we have several in this room. Maybe you can stand up. Coach trainers, Martin from Austria, another from Austria, Urte, Israel, Stas, and Ranjit over there. So we have four of them. And hey, Carlos, stand up. Carlos, stand up. Five. I forgot nobody. No. We will explain how it works soon. We'll develop better later. How they are trained and certified. But it helps to the coaching education of a country, because now they have in the country someone who can conduct the courses. And in harmonization with several other experts from Europe, in this case from Asia, in the case of Ranjit. And of course, we still have a lot of countries that do not have yet a national coaching certification program. We help them with coaching courses. Some of them are funded by Olympic Solidarity, some of them are funded differently, self-funded or by a partner. We help also the coach education with some scholarships. That means we grant scholarships to some coach, and with this scholarship they can work during several weeks, 1 month, even more, depends on the money available. They can work every day in a center like Bangkok, for example, it's one of them. Every day they can work with a high-level coach, a national team. It's a good system because the education is not so intense. It is spread over a longer period of time, allowing hands-on, allowing practical education. In a traditional coaching course of 1 week, 10 days, 2 weeks, will depend, it's quite intense. The participants receive a lot of information and they practice. Some of you have already attended our courses, you see there is a big practical part in our course. But it's so condensed that it's difficult to master all this exercise, all these teaching tips. And another part that is growing, we help many countries to get more professional coaches. It could be from simply, we have a budget, we are looking for a coach. So we discuss what kind of coach they want, more recovery oriented, both, more for use. Is it to work in a center or is it to travel around the country? So we figure out what, and we, language also is important, cultural background. And from there, we try to find the appropriate candidate. Or sometimes we help them in funding, but it's become tough. Very tough. So this is most of our activities. Oh, I forgot one. Ah, yes. How to explain this in better words? There are countries who have developed a national coaching certification program that is very successful. So sometimes instead of reinventing the wheel, due to the cultural similarity, geographical similarity, we recommend to a country, you should contact this country because they are quite the same as you and they have already an efficient system. Maybe you need some little adaptation, but due to the geographical size and the sport organization of the country, it's quite similar. Just few adaptations, you don't need to rewrite all. So, and we think that this, having countries with their own national coaching certification program, there is some sort of competition between them. They want a better program than the neighbor, and every time we try to improve our program, so we think it's a good dynamic, this kind of competition between the quality of program. So, with the former committee, the first thing we consider is what is our philosophy of coaching. There are different ones, and I don't say we have chosen the right one. You have to think to the particularities of your countries. But with the former coaches committee, we thought that the coach is here as a partner, a guide also, partner, a collaborator of the archer. The archers, the development of the archers, the main, how to say this, the main person in charge of the development of the archer is the archer himself or herself. We help, of course. So this is our concept, which means that in our education, we teach the coach to observe, we teach the coach to analyze, we teach the coach to provide feedback to the archers, you know, and after this kind of discussion, to plan something specific for this archer. It's an individualized program every time. So this is our concept. We'll explain a little bit more after, but I think you have understood. It's not the only one, of course. There are several others. I will just name one, but I'm sure there are several. There is a kind of more military way where the coach, where the federation has adopted one strong school and people have to implement this school. They implement or they are out. That's it, they have no choice. But it works well also. Because it's easy to create harmony with the coaching because you have only one way, that's it. Of course, the problem is for archers. If you have a huge number of archers, it's good. because some will not adapt themselves to this kind of guide, strict guide, guidelines, and they will be out. So you need quite a lot of archers. The problem with the first one, it's a long education, much longer, because we have to help the archers, the coach, sorry, to develop the skills, the knowledge and skill of many techniques, many training concepts, and choose the proper one for a specific archer. It's much more work. You understand? The two main ones. The pitcher are characteristic. I'm sure this lady is not so. But it just, I think it gives us a good idea. So, still about the concept. You have the progression of an archer here. During his or her progression, he works first with a level 1 coach, probably in a club, then in red with a level 2 coach, probably at the provincial level, state level, whatever, and in yellow with a high level coach in a center like as he introduced Amdena this morning, on with national team, whatever, with someone with better caliber, if I can say. That means, of course, always, according to our concept, with the participation of the archer. We don't instruct, we coach. That means we help, we are partner of this progression. Understand? So this is why, because one archer work with different coaches, I don't remember many archers who have always been coached by one person. Most of the archers, we have to be trained by different coaches. So, due to this, it's important that all these coaches work in harmony. If you are in charge of coaching education in your country, it's a very important task to make sure that there is a regular communication, exchange, collaborations between these people. If not, what could happen? Some way of shooting, some way of training have been developed, for instance, here, and when the archer moves to this level, he's facing a new situation, and it's time to adapt to this situation, and sometimes don't adapt and disappear, give up. Okay. But if they work the same way, the transition is quite okay and the progression carry on. We cannot coach the same way exactly, for sure, but in harmony it's possible. Carry on? Another explanation of this concept, of this philosophy, is, you see the red line here? This is a caricature. Let's say this is the path of the progression of the coach in archery. Most of us, we have progress at the beginning and we have faced some difficulties, sometimes even we have shot not so good, and we progress, we found a solution, and all of us, we have shot normally, and we have reached a certain level of performance in our sport. Okay. What we want as a coach, in black now you have the path of our students. What we try to do as a coach is our student getting a better level than us. No? Yes, I hope. If not, you should ask yourself why you are in this coaching system, and if possible faster, with less deviation, time lost in experimenting wrong things and so on. Okay, you understand the illustration? But if we do well, all of us, we are experimenting something a bit strange, which at some time we have to work with archers who have reached a higher level than us. That means they are operating in at a level that we don't know. We have no experience. We know, of course, we know a bit by reading, by observing and all, but we have not this experience. So this is why there is always a transition, and sometimes we say, okay, now I cannot help. I ask another coach to take care of this archer because this coach has this experience and so on. It's an illustration, of course it's not perfect. This is the same explanation, a bit different. You have a beginner in a wild here, who also will progress, hopefully. And you have the coach, who hopefully progress also. Progress also because year after year, he can accompany the archer, the beginner, further, a longer time. But there is one period when we say maybe it is time for this archer to work with a coach of with more experience and all. Maybe at the provincial level, maybe at the state level, I don't know. Maybe in the national junior team, whatever. Understand? But hopefully the archer progresses again. And again, it is maybe time to go to national team A, B, whatever, and work in a specific training center or work on a national team. You understand the concept? So this is on what we have built our concept, our programs. We think that it is a duty of the coach to progress. It is a duty, and this progression is achieved by first an initial training, a coaching course, whatever. But this is what? Few weeks. In some countries, 1 week, 2 weeks. But it's very few. It's not enough. So it's very important that there is a strong continuing education program. To become a coach, it's not done in 1 week. It's impossible. So after a course, when you receive the certificate at the end of the course, the certificate just means we trust that now you have the capabilities to become a coach, but you are not yet a coach. Now there is a lot of work to do. What is good nowadays, we have a lot of opportunity. Here it's one. We have some seminars in some states. We have at the national level, continental level, world level, and we have internet. With internet you have a lot of documents available, a lot of video. What we hadn't in the past. And it's good to read, to get information, but we need also to experiment. It's a duty of the coach to experiment in order to master some training techniques, some teaching exercise, shooting exercise, whatever. So hands on. And finally, another important point is evaluation. Self-evaluation or evaluation by some other partner, collaborator, colleagues, whatever. If we are not evaluated, it's difficult to identify what we do wrong and well. We think we do either wrong, we think we do either well, but not sure. And this is a problem when you get experience and high level, there is less and less people to give you feedback, unfortunately. It's easy to give feedback at a level one coach, but when you reach a high level, your students and colleagues are reluctant to tell you, you should do this better. Difficult. So this is why it's important, again, to work often together. If we work alone, it's very difficult. Oops, sorry, let's see it. So we made the statistics years ago, we have to redo them. It was in 2007 in Leipzig World Championship. And it came out that most of those who have reached this international level needed about 7 years. 7 years from the novice level to international level. I don't know, I think this duration is not valid anymore. We should make better statistics. I think now we can shorten a bit this duration. But if it takes 7 years to make a good archer, how long it takes for a coach? Sure, it takes more time. So it's a very long process. Coaching education is a very long process. And most of you are in archery for how long? Well, you are above this, for sure. An experimented coach like Kisi, Kimion Tak, and so on. Long, long experience, of course. Okay? So about coaching in World Archery with previous committees, one of the first questions we had is, okay, we develop a coaching program, especially for the countries that have not yet a national coaching certification program. So what should we do? So first we have this philosophy, I have already explained. Due to this philosophy, we say, because we are here to help the archer, what is the usual progression of an archer? We try to sort out the different steps, so we sorted out 3. And for each of these steps, from novice to elite, we have identified what do they need as novice. What do they need when they reach the level 2? What do they need when they operate in high performance? And we have started to develop tools, a curriculum and tools program for each level. So it's mainly based on helping the archer. There are different concepts. Many countries, they divided coaching by geographical level. Club coach, state coach, national coach, whatever. Why not? But I don't think coaching skills depend on geographical level. It depends on who you are helping. So we can see here another explanation of these levels. But first, I would like to insist on this. We, World Archery, we do not certify any coach. There is no one World Archery coach in the world. No one. There is a misunderstanding on this for many years, I don't know why. You can read all the certificates we deliver. We certify an attendance participation to our course, but we don't certify you are a World Archery coach. You know? The only level we certify is coach trainer, but we will explain later. So anyway, we'll come back to our subject. So we have identified first the level for the novice. I don't know exactly how is archery in each of your countries, but in Western Europe, all America, even also in most some countries of Oceania, when we receive a beginner in the club, we don't know what bow, what discipline will shoot this beginner in 1 year. It's difficult to know. Will he or she shoot compound, bare bow, recurve, traditional bow? We don't know. In some countries it's easy because they just have target archery with recurve, some recurve and compound. But in most of our countries, we have so many disciplines and bows that later, at the level 2, the coach will have to help the archer who has completed the level 1 to become a specialist of one specific bow in 1 or 2 disciplines. Most of archers all over the world shoot 2 disciplines, one during winter, one during the nice days, the sunny days. So, according to this understanding, here at the level 1, we help the novice with generic basics of archery. That means skills, we develop skills that are valid for compound, bare bow, recurve, whatever. Understand? And only after the level 1 program, we help the beginner to adopt a specific bow for 1 or 2 specific disciplines. This is why our level 2 is made by modules, we will explain later. And of course, if the archer progresses, he will maybe reach an elite level where the needs are different. Now archers need to need assistance to reach the best performance possible. Here, many archers do some competition, but archery is a hobby. They just want to shoot arrows, doing cardio, strength, no. Many of them, even if they are competitors, they are recreational competitors, in fact. So you understand the concept also? If not, write your question down for later. So this is why we have developed 3 curriculums. For level 1, for level 2, and we're still working on level 3. I don't develop this. Now we can develop. So for the level 1, the task of the coach is to teach the common basics with no specialization in one bow, because we don't know if in 1 year, at the end of the program, he will shoot or she will shoot a compound, traditional, recurve, we don't know. Okay? The way we have developed the content of this education is to allow the coach to work with different beginners. Young, not young, disabled, valid one, in a school, in a recreational center, only one beginner or a group of beginners. So we have done this. The course we propose are 7 days long. 7 days is without evaluation. if there is a need of evaluation, it's longer, and if there is a need of translation, it's longer. So we have developed a manual some years ago, and we have this year released a new version of the manual. For those who haven't seen yet this manual, I will just show some pages. So it is what you can get from our website, sorry. As you see, you can click and move the pages. If you click here, here, or if you want to go faster, let's say these pages. It works a bit small, you know, sorry. But you have it online, we don't print it. You can download it. So for example, you have, when you reach, for example, stance, or when you reach Bohan, go ahead. Help me. You will enlarge a bit. Ah, thank you. So you have access for each, for example, each shooting skill to different exercises that you can use, of course. I'm sure there are other exercises that are not listed in this manual. So you are invited to send your suggestions to improve this manual, of course. So in this manual you have different items like safety, because it's important for the level one, how to teach, how to organize a entry level program, how to build a class, how to teach skills, of course, a lot of games also. Thank you. It's a beginner award program, is here also. So, we invite you, it's not mandatory, but it is 400 something pages with a lot of illustration, because we know most of the readers have not English as a mother tongue, so we made a lot of illustration for a better understanding. So, thank you to all the collaborators to this huge work. That lasted too long, but this is life. Okay, sorry. So you have the main contents are here. To attempt the level one, what we recommend is at least 2 years of practice as archer, of course. We send some documents to read before the course about doping, for example. And of course, we only work with coach candidates who are recommended by the National Archery Federation. We cannot work with individual people, it's impossible. So the level two, as we said, level two coach helps the archer to get specialist, to become a specialist of one bow for one or two disciplines. You remember? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah, hope so, If not, the memory is short. So, at this level, we kept in mind that many archers compete, but not seriously. Some of them seriously, so we have to keep this in mind because it's important for good results at the international level. But most of them are recreational competitors. So we don't speak yet really about training plan. The coach is more a technical advisor at this level. Not really yet a trainer. Understand the difference? So, because there are different boards, different disciplines, this manual, because we develop a manual here, it is also available online, it is made by modules. You have a modules for bare bone, modules for compound, a module for recurve, for target archery, for field archery, and so on and so on. But we have also generic modules for psychology, anatomy, physiology. Okay? We have a special module for para-archery. A little about the implant, but it's very poor. So this manual will be updated soon, in the near future. So the duration of a level 2 course depends on the number of modules on the program. When a country, for example, we had Malaysia asking an expert to conduct a level 2 course, and Mr. O.Q. Moon will conduct this course. So the first question to the organizer is, okay, you want a level 2, but for what? Because there is no one expert who can teach all. I think none of us can teach all the bows, from traditional to compound or whatever. It's very difficult. Or we are not so good in some of them. But when you have to teach anatomy, physiology, compound, recurve, bare bow, para and all, it's too many. So it's a course, it's a difficult course to, not difficult, but when you organize a level 2 courses, you often need several experts. You understand? Of course, it is open to people who have worked at least 1 year as a level 1. Usually, it's a real minimum. Before that, it's difficult to do a good level 2 course if you have not yet a good mastery. Level 3? So level 3 now is really, and for most of you, this is an interesting project. To work with elite archers. I see most of you, because this year we have several national coaches. Just for like this, how many works collaborate with a federation at national level, with junior, senior, B team, compound, doesn't matter. Please raise your hand, how many works at the national level? So anyway, national level, wait for the translation, national. So we have 15. You see? It's a big percentage. But the way to coach, to train elite archers is so different from one country to another one, due to cultural background, due to the connection with your national coaching program for all sport. In many countries, there is a generic sport education, both physiology, anatomy, sport legislation and all. And you have a specific training for the particular sport. So, depending how you want to cope with this program and the profile of this generic program, it's quite, there is different alternatives to coach elite archers. Of course, now we are working only with archers who have one bow and who practice in one or two disciplines, no more, of course. Okay, of course, it's for competitors, you know that. This picture is interesting because it shows that at a level 3, the coach has to work differently. Now you have seen the best team of the world. They don't come to major event only archers and one coach. They come with a real staff around the team. At the level 3, the coach has to work is a coordinator of a staff, a team with a psychologist, physical preparator, team leader, coach assistant in a club or in a province, whatever, searcher with university to conduct some researches. Here it's in Poland, they did a research about body balance. So the task of the, what we teach at the level 3 is mainly training plan, mainly. Because the technique is okay now. At the level 2 they have learned how to use a compound bow, a traditional bow, a recurve bow, whatever. Technique is done, normally, through the level 1 and level 2 coaches. So now it's mainly working on training plan, recuperation, preparation to competitions. So this is why it's difficult to say how long is a course of level 3, because if there is already a generic education about anatomy, physiology and all through a national sport governing body, we just have to make this training plan specific. Technique is done, they have already learned the psychology, the physiology and all, so we just come to indicate what is particular to our sport. If not, we have also to teach the generic education in physiology, psychology and all, which is longer. But usually in 5 days we can help the coaches to take care of elite archers if they have a good level 1, level 2 background. Of course, a candidate should have been level 2 coach for at least 1 year also. Okay, you follow? So now we talk about coach trainers. We have introduced the 5 who are here. We have a level 1 and a level 2 coach trainer. That means people who can conduct a level 1 coaching course and who can conduct a level 2. Level 2, we had only one session some years ago in Compiègne for Europe. So we have not yet a lot of experience, we can improve a lot. Level 1, we have already 5 experiences, so it's coming better. So level 1 is 10-day course. And during the course, each candidate is invited to conduct a part, to rehearse, if you want, a part of a coaching course, and we evaluate it. And after the course, the candidate have to submit preparation documents for the course, documents for the course organizer, for the participants, and the document to conduct the course, the PowerPoint. Whatever, doesn't matter. And they have to conduct a coaching course within 1 year with double evaluation, a self-evaluation and an evaluation from the participants. So it's a 1 year program. And when they are certified, they are certified for 4 years. And after 4 years, there is a recertification process quite similar to the judge one. Here we see a coaching course in Bangkok for Asia, Ranjit was there. So they receive a kind of patch. And you have here the names of those who are already certified from America, from Asia and Europe. Next session will be in Athens for Europe, Greece, in 1 month, less than 1 month. But we said there is no certification from world archery to the coaches. So this is something we can discuss, of course. So why? First, you know, in world archery we try, I hope you have this perception, we try to deliver quality services. We try to do good tournaments, good seminars and all. If we think we cannot do very good stuff, very good work, we don't do. And unfortunately, due to the lack of human resources and lack of money, we don't think that we can manage well to develop the best curriculum, to ensure a good continuing education, to evaluate all people involved in this program, and even to ensure a good continuing education to all these certified people. We have also to maintain or update the curriculum or all. There are so many coaches. In the past, when I arrived to FITA, we had a database of coaches, but we stopped because now it's thousands of coaches. It's too much. There are so too many. So to ensure the quality through such a huge number of coaches, it's a big challenge. Some federation can do, but we are not yet at the level like tennis and so on and so on. We are not the same human resources and all. So this is why. And second, also, there is another problem. Some nations, for example, don't want only coaches educated by them. I remember once in Australia, there was a misunderstanding. They thought that we had certified some of their coaches, so we received a strong letter. Why you have certified our coaches without our authorization? So they said, no, we just have delivered a certificate of participation. Read well, read it. And as I have already explained, we also trust that having national coaching certification program in different countries, there is a kind of simulation, you know, a good competition. Germany tried to get a better program than Italy and so on, and finally everybody progress. So this is why. We are almost at the end of this presentation. We are considering other alternative of educating the coaches. As you know, we have different profile of coaches. Some coaches are very eager of techniques. Some are more equipment oriented. I think this one is here.
No, he's not here.
No, yeah. But it's just an illustration. I'm not sure you are technical oriented. Sorry. Some are more physical oriented. Some are more better expert on the psychological side. Some are very good to help an archer during a competition. Some are good in training, but not always good in competition. It's different tasks. Some are very good as team leader. So maybe this is another orientation we will take in the future. I don't know. We still have to dig on this to propose a technical module, to propose a team leader module, to propose a physical module, in which, of course, there will be succession for beginners for level 2 and level 3, of course. So think a bit of this. After my lecture, we can discuss of this if you want, of this alternative. What time it is? Sounds good. We are on time. So, very often now, we have to ask ourselves, I am good as a coach. What is a good coach? think a bit, answer for yourself, what is a good coach? Okay? According to you, what is a good coach? Let's see if we have the same vision. What is a good coach?
Someone who wants help the archer to develop them.
It's a concept that we agree totally with.
I believe the coach has to have good desires, that's why the archer has to achieve.
Desire to
achieve.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely. Stop loudly if not the translator cannot hear. Loudly.
A good coach educate themselves, make further education. Don't stick on the same level.
Fully agree also. But view from your boss. Let's say if you are a national coach, view from your National Archery Federation. What is the main criteria on which the federation will say, well, this coach is good?
If you provide winners, medals.
Provide good results.
The coach makes the archers progress.
And
they can achieve the results.
Because medals, I don't know, if you take Sierra Leone, for example, they are not yet at the level to win medals. But if the national coach makes the archers from Sierra Leone progressing, the federation is pleased, of course. So pleased and maybe win some medals if they are already in high level, but if they are at the bottom of the pyramid, not yet. But as long as a coach makes archers progressing, normally, your boss, that means your club, your provincial association, or your national archery organization should be pleased. So, this is the main point, how to make our archers progressing. And this is the main concern of a coach. And it's not a problem of certification. It helps, definitely it helps. But it's not because you are certified that you are a good coach. Now you have to make archers progressing. Understand? The certification just is a recognition of your potential, but the work has to be done now. So, first, if we want to elevate the level of our successive students, archers, but probably we have to improve ourselves. We have to progress ourselves. If we don't progress, it will be difficult because the opponent, the other coach from other nations, progress. So we have to progress. Definitely through continuing education, evaluation and all. Of course, experiments, experience and all. So this is the reflection I would like to introduce with you. How to make a strong archery nation? So what we usually the country expects some progress on the continental or international level, of course. And we consider that we need four things to progress. Four. These four are listed here, and we will develop each of them. This is in yellow, it's still important. The next one, no. The contract is very important. The commitment of the coach, written commitment of the coach, a written commitment of the archers on goals, progressive goal. Year after year, or every second year, there should be a more challenging objective. Progressive, if not. We have to instill the dynamic of progression on the national teams. It will not come like this. Or if it comes like this, it will disappear also like this. It has to be developed. And with this kind of contract, I commit to do my best to achieve this, and next year to achieve this and this. Of course, there should be this dynamic. This is not important. So rapidly, because some of you have already attended to my courses, so you know this. It's not my, it's well assured. So we need good coaching certification, good coaching assistance at all levels for beginner, elite, everybody. We set a national coaching certification program, continuing education. Of course, this sport is becoming more and more professional. And this is why one of my questions to Alain Dehaene, how many professional coaches you have? Because if you want professional archers, you need professional coaches. You cannot let professional archers alone. They have to be coached. Definitively. And yesterday we discussed with the coaches committee, we say, oh good, now archers are more professional, coaches are more professional. Next step is maybe to make judges more professional. And also administrators of the federation. We are working on this. Of course, the coach should help the needs of all archers at all levels. In our sport, there is a need of, in all sports, in fact, in our sport we need some equipment, so it's important to have the facilities and good equipment, access to them. All year long, it's a problem still in some countries with winter and all. We need definitively needs to adapt the timetable at school or work. If not, it's difficult to compete because our opponents are more and more professional. So it's definitely a necessity here. We need access to different developments of strains and all here, so the facilities. And specialists. At high level, we are definitely have to collaborate with other specialists for health, for psychological development, research with university and all. We need a lot of strong schedule of tournaments at different levels. We need tournaments for beginners. We cannot make the beginners shooting right away 70 meters, it's crazy. So we need a different level of organization to prepare our elite to shoot, for example, with media coverage, with public around, good judges. You agree? Yeah. We have also to have some tournaments with media exposure. And of course, tournaments play in a fair way with no doping problem and so on. And finally, there is no organization in sport or whoever that is efficient without a good administration. We need a strong administration. What does it mean? Oh, it's the same. No, so I did a mistake, so sorry. No, it's the third one. Okay, I come in. That is good administration. Sorry for the confusion. Yeah, come in. So, what does it mean, good administration? A plan. The organization should know where they are going. There should be a clear understanding in which direction the organization, your club, your provincial association, your national archery federation, they should have a plan. In a, for us now, when a country asks for assistance from World Archery, first question, what is your plan? You have no plan? We don't help. Finish. We spend too much time helping countries that didn't know where they are going. It's a waste of time. If you have a plan, okay. In this plan, where you need help? And now we can discuss. So, something very important that is not yet done, even by us for Rashi, we are progressing, but we have still to improve, recognition. A good administration should value the collaborator, the volunteers, the coaches, the archers, the judges, everybody. This is very important, and it's not well done. We can do better here. Decision process. In many countries, there are conflict because decisions have been taken strangely. The decision process is not clear, not fair. Communication is a key, I think, of a good administration. And nowadays it's much easier with the internet and all. In other words, it all should be very transparent, important. And, of course, the management of the budget. If the money is poorly spent to stupid things, after we say, we cannot compete there because we have not money, because we spent money to have dinner with the executive board and whatever. No, of course. So, this is the conclusion of my lecture. Sorry, it was a bit not long. We are on time. I would like to say archery has changed a lot. The competition is no longer between talented archers and talented coaches. No, now we have to be realistic. The competition is between the level of professionalization of the nations, even of the clubs, even of the provincial association. If your country is more professionally organized than mine, your country would be better, quite sure. Maybe sometime in a lucky day I will have a good result, but overall, no, your country would be better. So this is why it's a big challenge for the coach. Oops. The coach must absolutely contribute to this. Coaching is no longer a technical area. We have to help a good administration. We have to help a good network of tournaments. We have to help good training services, with training center, with facilities available, all this. If we don't do, who will do? So we have to spend time out of the range with administrator and all to make archery progressing. And this is a really growing challenge for us in charge of coaching education. And on this, I hope it was not too long. And you have enjoyed this lecture. Thank you for your attention. So we open the floor to comments or questions. Yes, Martin. Martin and Tim.
What are you working for the coach trainers just now? What you are developing for the next levels? And in which direction are you going to improve us as a coach trainer?
Yeah. So the coach trainer is really a new program, and it will take some years to refine it. So level one is now quite set, I would like to say. So at the level one, as you know, we try to help you to first well prepare the course. It's important. A good preparation is 80% of the success of the course. Yeah? And to conduct it, we help a bit. At the level two, we have definitively to improve. Because, as you saw, we have to start to teach some different modules, generic modules, archery-specific modules. So we'll have a second experience early next year. I don't remember the date, in March or April in Greece. and we are preparing it with Elena. You remember maybe some of you, Elena from Romania, who is a physiotherapist, so has some expertise in generic sport education. After that, we'll see better what to do. After two attempts, we'll have a better understanding. Of course, our goal to answer to your question is in the future to educate level 3 coach, trainer. Of course, that means educate people who will be able to educate national coaches, if we summarize like this. So this is where we are going, of course, but there is still some time is required to refine this. But this is where we are going, yes.
And how long do you think that you will take to finish this three steps program? Can you see the end by now, or can you say, we don't know?
No, we don't know, but it will speed up. Why? Because, as I explained, at the moment, the Department of Development and Coaching is Deka and me, so it's very few staff. And as soon as you know, we are in 1 year, we'll open a World Excellence Center in Lausanne, and we will reorganize the work in World Archery. Normally, development will move with the center. And myself, I will continue some years coaching education only. So there will be more time to finish this kind of projects, because without development, it's a lot of work. You know, in development, we handle about 200 projects per year. We started with 15 projects in 2000. Now we have about 200. It's a lot of work. So there is some light to produce more. As we explained yesterday with the coaches committee, in the past, we had a committee who was supposed to help us with development. But the problem is the members who are in charge of a national team are too busy. Kim Jong-tak, even Mr. Kissick here, have no time to write manuals, develop this kind of program. They are too busy. And those who are no longer coaching are very often out of date. Understand? So it was a big concern. So we are reorganizing all this and on a good way to be more efficient. So, to answer to you, I think before Tokyo Olympic Games, the whole program will be finished. I hope. My God.
Hi, Pascal. I've been asked to stand up. Tim Swain from Archery GB. We also have been developing our Level 3 course for 4 years, nowhere near finished, so we'll race you to the end. You made a comment in your presentation about it took about 5 years to develop a world-class archer, and a similar time for a coach. We seem to have a concept of 10 years in the UK to develop a master archer, and I have a concept of, and we have a concept of about 10 years to develop a master coach. So I was wondering where you got that 5 years from.
It was not 5 years, it was after Leipzig Olympic Games, after a survey, it was 7 years even. It was. Now maybe it is faster because we have improved some training techniques and all. But we have to redo a survey to sort out this. But it was a survey made on the competitors in Leipzig Olympic Games. 7 years, it was in 2007, I guess.
Yes. And we're finding with our coaches, we get a lot of interest at level one, but very few progress to level two and beyond. And what they are citing to me is a lack of confidence to go further. They are worried about the technical demands of level two. Is that something that people are finding generally around the world, or is that a UK, a British thing, do you think?
So I think everybody can answer. I think in many countries it's the same. We have many candidates at the level one and much less after, no? Yes or no? Yeah, I saw some head moving. Yeah, many. Many because I think there are still many participants coming for their own education. Many. For helping a club, it's okay. With beginner, okay. But helping at a higher level, of course, it's more, as you say, we need some confidence because it is more challenging, definitively, yes.
Yes, but I mean, we're hearing from our coaches, it's particularly observation and analysis.
Yeah.
And is that something you've built into level two to help people?
Yeah, in level one we do, already, yeah, analyzing, observing, and all the always.
Yes.
Yeah. But of course, when we progress, we use different tools. So that means for level one, eye observation is enough. But at a higher level, we use some software with a slowdown video and this. Yeah. We teach this.
Okay, thank you. I'd be very interested to talk to anybody that's got anything to add to that outside.
Thank you. There was another one, Masid, I think. Masid from Turkey. Hope you know this name.
Pascal, I have a question about the coaches who are applying to your programs. Have you found any differences among the coaches in terms of performance and success, depending on if they were archers before they applied to your coaches' courses, or just a person who is interested in archery and applying to your courses? Is there any difference between these two groups? Thank you.
So it's a question, I think, for everybody also. I think everybody has some answers. Of course, I am involved in coaching education for many, many years. And it's obvious. It's easier for me as a coach trainer to make a coach from an archer. To make an archery coach from an archer. It's easier, of course. Nevertheless, I'll give you one experience. When I was in Canada, you know, Canada, I was coaching Canada during two Olympic periods. There were 27 million of inhabitants in a huge country, very huge. You know, in Canada, when we say, this year the national is only 2 hours of flight, we say, oh, good, it's not far. It took me more times and it was cheap, more expensive to visit my president in Victoria Island than to go to Paris. You see, it's a huge country. So, how to train archers? I cannot train archers at all hours of plane from my city. So I had to work with people who sometimes have no archery experience. I give you an example with Marie-Pierre Baudet, maybe you remember her. Marie-Pierre Baudet was a daughter from a bow hunter. He was shooting, but bow hunting, nothing to do with archery, of course. And so they asked me to train her. I said yes, but she's living far away. How to follow her? You have to find a coach with whom I will collaborate. No coach. I say, so I cannot. And the father said, can you try with me? Oh, I'm third. Oh my God. We can try. And we did well because Marie-Pierre Baudet got all world record in cadet girl. So it's possible. But it, through such a collaboration, alone he could not have became a good coach. If he has attended only 1 week of course and finished, I suspect he will not have got these results. But with assistance, of course, it's possible. Okay, if it's that's it. Ah, one more? Oh, Carlos, sorry, Carlos. Carlos Freitas from Portugal.
Hello, everybody. So, two things that are related to what Pascal was saying. So, my main experience, besides being the responsible for developing the education programs for the Portuguese Archery Federation, is also been working as a coaching course conductor or coach trainer with World Archery for the last 3 years. And I've taught courses level 1 and level 2 in Europe, Africa, and Asia. And one of the things that I think we could talk a little bit more, and I think it's important, is first the need for the continued follow-up with the students after the courses. So my experience tells me that this is one of the big problems, is that even on the countries that do it the first time, after 1 year or 2 years, they might do another one, but they still go back to the level one. And this is because there is really not so much follow-up. So what can we do and what can World Archery do to assure that there will be some form of follow-up after we actually finish to give the courses? And the second one that I think it should be talked also, we already talked a little bit on the program, is the link between the administration and the structure. Because again, if the national championships or the competitive structure of the tournaments is not developed at the same level and develop the coaches, then the country will not progress. So we are making coaches in countries that sometimes do not have a competition or a national championship program, and then the coaches, they don't really have an objective to continue working because there are no competitions. So how can we help to make this link between the service providing and the coaching education? Thank you.
Thank you for your two questions. Maybe the answer is different from one country to another one, depending on the profile. But about the first question, how we can help the kind of continuing education after the initial course. We have some projects here. The first is the e-technical and training library, where you will have access to many suggestions to improve some psychological skills, physical skills, technical skills, and all. It's one project. But even now, you have some opportunities. On internet, you can find many, many suggestions about many developments already. After that, it's very fundamental that the development is not done individually. The development should be done collectively in a club, in a state, or in a nation. That means the coaches have to work, progress together, exchange often together. If there is not this, if it is not organized in your club, in your provincial association, or in your national archery federation, I suspect you will face a limit. Only if there is a collective dynamic, you will progress. As we have explained, we cannot, it's very difficult, very seldom, an archer progress all his career long with the same coach. We have to collaborate. We have to, sometimes an archer has to work with another coach because he needs to go in a sports school system, he needs whatever, to go to a national training center like they are in Spain or whatever. So it's important, this. But for us, yes, our goal is to develop e-learnings. Through e-learnings, through this kind of seminar that we propose every second year, we also give some money to your continental archery association to organize some tools and seminars and all. In America, they restart the former program for coaches that was existing years ago, very often in Mexico. In Asia, every second year, there is a coaching seminar. Asia, we have not so many. We arrange it and some Korean. And in Europe, there is also some courses available. The other continent, unfortunately, not yet. But it's really a national concern. We were discussing yesterday with Mr. Kisik. He is organizing also every beginning of year a kind of workshop. You invite your coaches and you make continuing education. It has to be done. It's in the responsibility of your coaches committee. You should have one. And the second one was about developing a sport like us. We saw four components of development. There are different things that have to be developed at the same time: facilities, equipment, judging, education, sport administration, all this. And yes, this is why coaching education is becoming challenging, because the coach has to help the organization to highlight, I do my best, but as long as we have such poor tournaments, as long as we have such poor judging, as long as we have no good media coverage, I'm limited. This is something. We have to spend time out of the range with the organization with whom we work to highlight the problem, make suggestions. It is. The strong nations, you know, they are not strong like this. It's because all is developed. If one department is weak, problem. And it is really, I think, the task of the coach to report. Here in our organization, we have a weakness, and we should do this. If you don't do this, I'm not sure the people in charge of the organization will realize the problem and will have any suggestion in mind. Even when we have suggestion, it's difficult to make them accepting and all. But yeah, this is a strong concern. In some countries, they have a high-performance director or committee who is supposed to look at this. It should be in each organization. So thank you for your attention.